Hello, I'm Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is a continuation of Christianity. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And here I render exposition of gospel by John 16. Verse 20-23. Jesus said to his twice born laboring solitary brethren / friends. Jesus had no disciple. The root of the word disciple is discipline. And you discipline the natural boys 12 to 16 years old through the moral of Moses. So the rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, they used to have disciples. Not Jesus. So this is a corruption by the Messianic Jews. So brethren and friends, not the once more natural disciples of the crook rabbis who disciplined them through the moral laws of Moses. They did what their rabbis told them to do. Thus Saul, being the disciple of Rabbi Gamaliel, did obey him obediently as required of him, and persecuted the laborers of Jesus. And in his own heart or subconscious, he was not happy for the disciples doing what their rabbis tell them to do. They are called spiritually blind, with no freedom or free will. Thus the substitute disciple and Lord are the corruptions by the Messianic Jews to set up the same temple system from the yoke of which Jesus set us free by giving his own life as the Lamb of God. For these robed, hireling, dog-collared priests in the churches of Mammon have fulfilled Matthew 12, verse 43-45, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus, the anointed Christ of our supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. They mean the same thing, you know, supernatural. The natural one is Yahweh, Brahma, and Khuda. So Jesus said, Amen, Amen, I say to you, you will weep and mourn while the world rejoices. You will grieve, but your grief will become joy. Now he gave a comparison to, you know, what type of joy you will have. When a woman is in labor, she is in anguish because her hour has arrived. But when she has given birth to a child, she no longer remembers the pain, but because of her joy that a child has been born into the world. So Jesus is giving a good comparison that how a woman, when after giving birth to a child, loves his child and is so joyful. So you also are now in anguish that he is going, you know, being killed, you know, by these Messianic Jews, temple priests turned Christians. But I will see you again as a newborn child, and your hearts will rejoice, and no one will take your joy away from you. On that day, you will not question me about anything. Amen, amen. I say to you, whatever you ask the Father in honor of my name, he will give you. What we ask from our Father is not material thing. We ask from our Father gospel treasures. And gospel treasures we receive on logical reasoning which Jesus has introduced, that always think logically. The end product of logical reasoning is logo. So when we preach gospel, then more we spend, more is given to us. When we preach gospel, we glorify our Father in honor of Christ Jesus, because he has the one who has introduced to us our Father in this dark age. This is dark age. The rabbis had become crook. So I will leave it here.